I would say the hardest player in the NBA to guard is probably Shai.
He's just always been super smart, super cerebral.
He's just always aggressive. You know, he's always a threat out there every time you guard him.
He's fine-tuning his game in many different ways.
He's just continued to grow.
As a teammate, as a leader, you know, he's just a warrior.
Shai is going to be so good.
Me, Bam, and Malik actually went back after we got drafted, and the guys were there, and Shai was kind of the not necessarily unknown guy, but I don't think he was McDonald's All-American, and they had a couple, and I think he was like the lowest ranked out of the guy. I think he was still like top 50 or whatever, but he was like the lowest ranked out of all the guys, and we go and we play pickup. I'm like, yo, I think he's going to be the best player on the team. I truly believe that at the time, and then like midway through the season, he ends up taking the starting spot, and now he's an MVP candidate.
Man, it's been really cool playing with Shai, because one of the biggest things from the younger generation as they come through the NBA, you can't tell what hand they are, like if they right-handed or left-handed. Like the way Shai uses his off hand is crazy, you know what I mean? So it's a lot of plays, like we'll be in a timeout and I'll be like, look Shai, when I used to go by people, this is the play that I would run, so now we're gonna run it for you, you know what I mean? So his ability to get to the rim and his ability to draw fouls and all that, it's been cool to see.
I said it last year, watching all these games, you know, no matter what happens, you might only remember him, you know, maybe missing four shots in a row or something. And then at the end of the game, you look up and he has 30. So it's like, no matter what happens, whether, you know, he makes it look easy, which he does a lot of nights, or whether the defense is really tough on him, you know, you look up and, you know, he's Shai. So, It's easy to take for granted, but we don't do that. We know the type of player he is and the type of guy he is, and we're happy to have him.
Shai's had a hell of a year. I remember playing against him in high school, playing against him when I was on the USA team back in high school. He's just always been super smart, super cerebral. A taller guard who knows how to use his body. Someone with that type of skill set is going to be able to adapt to, the NBA game quick, and he's done that. So, he's a big reason why, their team's been having success this year, so it's good to see it.
Yeah, he's tough. He's tough. Shouldn't say that because he went to UK, but he's tough. He's a good player. You know, his court vision, his poise, his teammates respect him, and at a young age, that's something that's really, really impressive, you know, that teammates respect and his work ethic and the way he plays. He's fine-tuning his game in many different ways. He's able to get to his spots. Never seems too out of control, and I think that's one thing. He can only get better, and he's tall too. So as a point guard, it definitely helps.
That's what he does, especially when they have floor space the way they do, and some of the offense they run. Like everybody's kind of a threat out there, and you know he takes advantage of the driving angles, and he's making tough contested twos. Part of it is kind of shots you live with, but not that many. So that's what the league is about, like, you know, scores of his caliber, winning games for a team by hitting tough shots.
Do you think of the year that Shai Gilgeous-Alexander has had for both the Thunder and for Canada?
Amazing. He's playing really well on both ends of the floor as well, which is, I think, most people talk about. But he's just always aggressive. You know, he's always a threat out there every time you guard him. And so it was nice to watch him lead the team and Team Canada getting that bronze.
Well, I seen Shai come out and wanted to impose his will on the game early. You know, 25 points, he got him going to start the game. He had 14 in the first quarter, I think. And knocking down the three, getting to the rim, putting pressure on our defense. I mean, he played with no fear tonight, and that's what kept him in the game most of the game.
I would say the hardest player in the NBA to guard is probably Shai, because he has so many counters. And, you know, I think, like, sometimes if you stop him from doing something, he goes to the counter. If you stop him from doing that, he has multiple counters at all times.
You know, what's crazy is that I know I'm probably like a burden on Shai at times. You know what I mean? But it's funny, he was in the rookie game last night and the ball went out of bounds and he went and got the ball really quick and tried to get it to the ref to rush it up the court. And because he sees me do that all the time during the regular season. So some of the stuff that I think I say to Shai all the time, sometimes he don't want to hear it, but he's starting to see, because he like to jump on pump fakes. You know what I mean? But Shea is going to be so good.
And just his poise, the way he plays, his length. Obviously, he's a lot stronger than he was at the time. He's just continued to grow. And I mean, we're throwing hits at him, blitzes, just trying to get the ball out of his hands. And being that tall, being that crafty, being that strong, that's a tough cover for any team. And obviously, he averaged 30 last year for a reason. And that team has done nothing but put the right pieces around him. They've gotten better, and he's still doing what he does. So just a lot of credit to what he's becoming.
You know, he's a warrior. You know, he's a dog, and knowing that he couldn't, you know, even though he got hit, he couldn't let his team down. And, you know, it's great to see him, you know, come back and still, you know, doing his thing and still trying to lead us. And, you know, that's just Shea as a person and as a teammate, as a leader. You know, he's just a warrior.
He understands that by him screening and him kind of being in the action sometime as Falstaff opens up the floor. You know, I've kind of seen the way we play. Even if I can't get a shot off, it just gives him more space to kind of maneuver around. And I think we've all kind of done a good job of that. And he understands, you know, kind of giving himself up to get a better shot. And, you know, just kind of the way we play, like the ball kind of finds him regardless. And he understands that. So, yeah, just able to make a play for me. And I was able to kind of repay the favor.
Shoot, I mean, you just see it so much over the course of time. You know that when he drives, he's going to, you know, either grab somebody from the baseline, or the person that's at the top is going to, you know, try to trap the spin or whatever. You just know to find windows. And when we find windows and just play on the catch, you know, we're a hard team to beat. So every time he drives, if he doesn't draw two, then he's getting a bucket. You know, it's Shea. So when he draws two, it's just about us finding cuts and finding the windows, so whenever he does get ready to pass it, he has an outlet. And then from there, we just play on the catch.
Yeah, he does a good job of getting the paint and then getting that bump. And that little bump that he gets creates separation enough for him to turn around and shoot or get a pump fake and then create the contact. So when he gets that bump and bumps you in the paint as you're backing up, it's important to be able to absorb that so that he doesn't get that space to feel comfortable.
I think it's the fact that it's actually happening. Our whole lives, like, we've talked about it, dreamt about it, and for me to, like, be here with his dad and, like, someone who was there our whole entire life, like, raising us to compete, to learn, to love how to compete against each other, make each other better, and now that it's actually here, it's surreal, and, like, I'm just grateful that God's given the opportunity, and I feel like I'm living through him right now.
He's always been very in the moment, you know, on and off the court, and a great teammate, just supporting other guys, giving them confidence. But, you know, in terms of his individual game, just, I don't know, I mean, his quickness and his balance and his strength, I mean, he can do it all out there, you know. And, you know, just his ISO situations this year, he's been phenomenal, and it's just opened up the court for everybody, you know. And and he's making that pass, you know, to the perimeter, you know, to keep the double off him, you know, at times. But just his aggressiveness, you know, and his consistency this year has just been, you know, amazing to watch and a blessing to play with.
Obviously a great scorer, and does a good job of using his body to one, get fouled and create space. So just as a basketball mind, of course it's fun playing against players like that. So, yeah, I mean, that's that.
Yeah, and the thing I always give him credit for is, like I said, he wants to be a participant in a great team. He doesn't just want to be a great player in a silo. I mean, he wants to help build a great team, and he's been a great, you know, factor in that up until this point, and he backs it up with the way he plays, and so he creates great space for his teammates, for a guy that, you know, is as talented and as ambitious as he is. He's just got an incredible balance of that.
Very difficult. Like I said, when Shea's attacking the basket, getting to the paint, and then you have shooters all around him, it makes it very difficult because, you know, he's the primary ball handler. He's the primary target as far as who we want to stop. And when he's getting into the paint, you know, he got to the 18 free throws, like I think against Sacramento the other day. And then, like I said, tonight he just lives in the paint. So when you try to take that away and they have great shooters around them, they're making shots, they're a tough team to beat.
He's a really good young player. You know, for a rookie to come in and attack with confidence the way he did, that shows you what he's about. So I thought he was great. He really hurt us, especially in that first half. And I thought we did a better job on him in the second half. But he's got a great future.